We invite you to become a partner and join Dr. Bill Winston as he trains believers how to live independent of this world system and have dominion over it. The Believer's Walk of Faith is paid for by Bill Winston Ministries partners and viewers.
The Word Network is your home for the best Christian programming and ministries on the planet. And now you can see it all and hear it all again. And again, and again. Introducing the new Word Network Replay. We've added a new DVR player on our website that lets you go back and watch everything we've aired over the last 48 hours. That's right. If you missed Bishop Jakes in the morning, no problem. Busy on Friday nights and can't catch Rejoice in the Word? Well, now you can. Feeling down and could use some inspiration from Joyce Meyer? We've got you covered. It's the new Word Network Replay, and it's only on thewordnetwork.org. Live stream what's on now or rewatch anything that's aired the last 48 hours. The Word Network Replay, bringing you everything you want, everything you missed, and everything in between. Be inspired and uplifted by Joyce Meyer, right here on the Word Network. Bishop Herman Murray, right here on the Word Network.
The level of your power is connected to your lifestyle.
At 6 o'clock p.m., right here on the Word Network. This is a Word Network special presentation.
To rejoice in the Word. Back and better than ever for its 10th season, it's Rejoice in the Word with Bishop George Bloomer, featuring Craig Mizell and the Rejoice in the Word Band. Coming to you live from a new studio at the world headquarters of the Word Network every Friday night. So get ready to be inspired, uplifted, and to experience a move of God like never before. We have a special show coming up intended just for you, featuring your Rejoice in the Word correspondent, Gabby Ruffin. And now, here's your host, Bishop George Bloomer.
Well, it's Friday night, and I'm happy to rejoice with you on tonight. Tonight is going to be a little bit different. First, I want to thank you for allowing me to share with you and to spend this pre-Valentine's weekend with you before it gets going. And I want to talk to you tonight about love, relationships, God, family, finances, business, etc. I want us to have an intimate talk together. I have some guests, and we're going to be blessed by them. But we want to dedicate this Friday night to the love of God. Can you do that for me? To the love of God. To the love of God. And I want everyone who is going through very, very difficult times in your relationships, whether it's a husband and a wife, or a mom and a son, a father and his daughter, cousins, whatever it is, I want you to listen to me for a little while, and maybe we can fix some things in your life. Maybe it doesn't have to end with the argument you just had. Possibly, the word of the Lord could be working in your life when it says, "For we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and are called according to purpose." Could it be that your crisis and your storm is calling you to purpose? 855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD. And before you start blaming other people for the rocky times that you're having and the difficult times that you're having, I want you to look at the man in the mirror. Yeah, I believe Andre Crouch has something to do with assisting Michael Jackson in that song. It says, I'm looking at the man in the mirror. I'm asking him to change his ways. No message could have been any clearer. If you want to make this place, a better world, take a look at yourself and change. 855-730-WORD. I want you to call in tonight. We're going to be ministering on Let It Go. We're going to be ministering out of this series, The Year of the Release, No Suitable Mate. We're going to talk about those things, and you're going to walk in victory and in freedom. Now, I need 300 of you tonight to call and stand in agreement with me as my financial intercessors. I see you in the airports, and I see you in the grocery stores. I see you in the mall. I see you in the lobbies of churches. And you say, Bishop, I watch all the time. I'm always watching. Well, I want you to do more than just watch tonight. I want you to be one of my financial intercessors. I want you to help me stand in the gap that I can continue to do what it is that I do by bringing this uncompromised message of Jesus around the world. Remember, this is rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. And if you want things to change, and if you want things to turn around, and if you want things to get better, God has given you the ability. He placed a seed in your hand, and the seed that you sow is the crop that you're going to grow. You want love? Sow a little love. You want peace? Sow a little peace. You want forgiveness? Sow a little bit of forgiveness. That's what I'm talking about tonight. I'm already excited. I've asked the pomp and circumstance to stay home and the noise makers to stay home so that we can sit by the fire a little bit and have this little discussion so we can work some things out. And maybe if we can get it going right now, by the 14th, everything will be okay for you. Good? 855-730-WORD. Our offer tonight is no suitable mate. I'm going to talk to you about it. Actually, I'm going to be teaching out of this on tonight. Bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh, purging polluted relationships, no suitable mate. Dealing with those particular issues out of the word of the Lord. There are 58 promises in God's word, and I need 300 of you to call tonight and say, Bishop, I'm standing with you in your crusade and in your campaign to make sure that the needs that you have are met so that you can continue to do what you do. Your faithful seed of $58 is going to do it. Is going to do it on tonight, okay? So let's get ready to have a wonderful time in the Lord. It's about to happen. Look at yourself and get ready to change. Gabby, how you doing tonight?
Bishop, I feel amazing today. And we're going to start this show off with a rising star in praise and worship. Welcome Mark J singing Victory.
Come on, if you're in your house, I want you to jump on your feet and let's have a little church tonight. I want you to declare the victory over everything in your life. Come on. Hey. Now everybody just clap your hands like this. Come on. Now everybody sing. Oh, oh. Yeah. Sing. Oh. Hey. Song goes like this. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory.
When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the star, we'll no less day to sing God's praise as if we've just begun. Everybody is talking about heaven, but everybody that's talking about heaven ain't going there. Very few people talk about dying and going to hell, but a lot of people are talking about heaven. They want to go to heaven. Want to go to heaven. And most times when people want to go to heaven, they want to go to heaven because they're living in hell. I want you to escape the torment, the accusation, the misery, the poverty, the abandonment, the loneliness of hell on earth, and find heaven here by connecting with that one that can bring great, great satisfaction in your life. I've been reading a scripture for the past few months leading up into the new year. Now we're in the new year, so there's two scriptures I'm going to read to you tonight. The first one is Deuteronomy chapter number 15. It says, at the end of every 7 years, thou shalt make a release. I'm not going to let this go. At the end of every 7 years, thou shalt make a release. I'm not going to stop reading this scripture. At the end of every 7 years, thou shalt make a release. This is a year ending in seven, a year beginning in seven. It's the seventh year, 17. At the end of every 7 years, thou shalt make a release, and this shall be the manner of the release. Every creditor that lendeth aught to his neighbor shall release him from it and shall not exact it of his neighbor or of his brother, because it is called the Lord's release. The first thing I want you to understand tonight is that this is the year that everything that's been held back from you in the realm of the spirit is being released. Whew! I just felt that in my spirit. It's being released. Know that. This is the year of the release. 2017 is the year, your year, where you experience breakthrough like absolutely never before. It is going to happen to you. In fact, your angels have already descended. They are situating and moving things out of your way so that you can come into a healthy, healthy lifestyle with God, with yourself, and with your family. So up on the board behind me, you see the words relationship clinic. This guy sitting here in this chair, I was 396 pounds on 10 different medications. I'd preach my first service and go upstairs and have to take a nap between first and second service. I was bleeding through my toes. Diabetes had set in. I mean, just going through. And I had sort of kind of programmed my mind that whenever it happens, it happens. But it wasn't God's time for me. I needed to see a doctor. Dr. Jesus knows all about it. I needed to see a doctor. And so I started going to the clinic. And as I was going, I got talked into changing my lifestyle. And today, I want to teach you and talk to you about changing your life. Style. It happened for me and it can happen for you. I lost 170 pounds. No diabetes, no congested heart failure anymore. Not on any medication. The only thing I take is a B12 every now and then and some vitamins, and that's it. The same God that delivered me is about to give you a spiritual overhaul and a spiritual makeover tonight in the name of Jesus. 855-730-WORD. I want you to have the tools. In a few moments, I'm going to be signing this book and sending you this package. I'll call your name on the air and I'm going to sign my name on your book, and we're going to enter into a yoke-destroying covenant that you will have tremendous breakthrough in your life. 855-730-WORD. There's another scripture that I want to read tonight as I go into the teachings for tonight in this relationship clinic. It is 1 Corinthians chapter number 13. Many of you know it well. It says, though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, love, I become a sounding brass or tinkling cymbals. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understanding of all mysteries and of all knowledge, great day in the morning. I got all this thing going on. If I don't have charity, if I don't have love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, and have not charity, love, it profits me nothing. Now this is where it got me going. Verse number 4 says, charity suffers long. Number 1, it is kind. Number 2, it envies not. Number 3, it vaunteth not itself. Number 4, it is not puffed up. Number 5, it does not behave unseemly. Number 6, it seeks not its own. Number 7, it's not easily provoked. Number 8, thinketh no evil. Number 9, rejoices not in iniquity. Number 10, but rejoice in truth. Number 11, my God, beareth all things. 12, believeth all things. 13, hopes all things. 14, endureth all things. Charity never fails. So we got to have a discussion about love. We got to have a discussion tonight about love, because somewhere along the line, somebody told me something about love that doesn't exist in my vocabulary or my understanding of what love is, not according to the Bible. It is said that there are three types of love. Agape love, that is the love that's God himself. And then there's a filial love, which is the affection that a mother has for her sons and daughters and what have you. And then there's eros love, which is that, you know, that kind of love, that physical, sexual love desire. And I think a lot of people, when they hear the word love, they immediately go to that last love. Because if we follow what the Bible says about love, I'm coming up short. I don't know about you, but I'm coming up short when I talk about the love that God says. It says charity, love suffers long. It's long suffering, so it's patient. It's kind, and it envieth not. It ain't jealous of nobody. It doesn't puff itself up. It's not arrogant. It's not puffed up. It does not. It trusts all things. It hopes all things. It believes. I'm finding from this right now that maybe I do not have the love that the Bible says that you're supposed to have. And maybe the reason why a lot of us are in trouble, because our idea of love is not what the Word of God teaches us that love is. I wish I could talk to you and get you to respond honestly, because how many of you trust all things, believe all things, hope all things? Bishop, that's how I was. I was trusting him. I was believing him. Everything he told me. And then I found out it wasn't so. Are you telling me, Bishop Bloomer, that love can make a fool out of me? Well, that's what the songwriter said. Love, oh love, keeps making a fool of you. It will make a fool out of you if you do not pay attention. There's a difference between love and lust. And one would have to have a great understanding as to what is going on. Now, why is this tonight important? Because today is the 10th, and 4 days from now, we're going to be in Valentine's Day. And I wrote some things down about Valentine's Day, and not the story of Saint Valentine's, but Valentine's Day itself. And last year, the candy sales on Valentine's Day. So last year, the 2016, candy and gifts, the result, jewelry, $4.5 billion sold on that weekend. Evening out, $4.4 billion. The restaurants made it good. Flowers, $1.98 billion. Clothing, $2 billion. Candy, $1.7 billion on candy. Cards and gift certificates, $1.6 billion. Greeting cards, $1.4 billion. And the estimations of it for this year coming in 2017, they're believing that they're going to hit $4 billion for jewelry, and evening night out, $3 billion, and flowers, $2 billion, and clothing, $1 billion, and candy, $1 billion, and cards, $1 billion. And all of this is spent. And then there's the statistics how that certain men break up with the ladies this weekend so they don't have to give them clothes, candy, jewelry, or what have you. It's a crazy thing when you allow a date to define what your relationship is. That you're waiting on your job for someone to come and bring you a card and candy so you can celebrate your private relationship publicly amongst everyone in the office. And oh, you really, really, really feel bad when he doesn't come through for you. The suicide rate is up 17% 5 days leading up to it and 2 days after. That people would actually take their lives because someone did not give them jewelry, candy, flowers, cards, etc. You done lost your mind, girl. You're crazy. This is the hour you must understand. In this hour, the enemy is coming at you with everything, and you're sick in your pursuit, you're sick in your ideology, and you need a spiritual cleansing. And that's why it was important for us to do this relationship clinic tonight and minister to you before the demonic forces suggest to you that the way that you're thinking is proper and right. I want to break that curse in your life. And it's about to happen. 855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. We're going to go into a little worship, a little praise, so you can digest some of the things that we talked about, so that you can pull out your little pad and your pen and begin to write down right now to figure out whether or not you fit the qualifications of love, if you can love properly, or if you're being loved properly. And then there's some questions that you sent to me that I'm going to answer, and there's some suggestions that I'm going to make to you. But I want you to enjoy this holiday season, and you're not going to kill yourself this year, and you're not going to drink yourself to death, and you're not going to go and run with strange women and strange men because you're trying to pull something out of a hat that doesn't exist. I feel like this is an important night. And so if you just turned the television on and you heard me with the first part of it, stay tuned, because I think it gets better as we move throughout this night tonight. In a few moments, we're going to talk about what a man is looking for in a woman. And you might find out whether or not you're that or not. 855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD. The gift offer tonight is no suitable mate. You're getting the prayer cloth, a bottle of oil, $58. 58 promises in the Word of God. And as you sow that seed, you're placing a dollar on every promise in God's Word. And you're going to walk in victory and in breakthrough in Jesus' name. Now, I want to call your name on the air tonight as a point of contact so I can connect with you, and I want to sign your book. I need 300 of you to do it. Go to the phones. Start calling now. I'm believing God for you. I'll be back in a moment. Gabby, what you think about tonight?
I'm excited about tonight. This is good, Bishop. People need this. And coming up now is a classic music moment featuring praise and worship powerhouse Shayna Wilson-Williams singing her hit single, Press in Your Presence.
Somebody just open up your mouth right here and just worship him with us. Father, we want to press in your presence because we know in you, God. We have faith in you. We have trust in you. Somebody worship. We glory in your presence. We press into your presence. We love your presence. If I can just press in your presence, behold the beauty of your face. If I can just press in your presence and never leave this place again. If I can just press in your presence and leave all my cares behind me, I will behold, I'll still believe, I will just lay at your feet, for I will behold, I'll still believe.
Your face, God.
I can just press.
Take my heart, take my mind, take my soul, never let me go. You heard the words of that song? Take my heart, my mind, my soul, never let me go. There's only one person in the universe that you could say that to, and that's God. Because you better be careful. You better be careful when you say to another person, I trust you with my heart. I trust you with my mind. I trust you with my soul. I trust you with it. I just got finished talking to you about love and what love is. And it can't possibly be that in your life. Love suffers long. Love is kind. It envieth not. It doesn't vaunt itself. It's not puffed up. It does not behave unseemly. It seeks not its own. It's not easily provoked. Lord, help me in the name of Jesus. It thinks no evil. Now, wait a minute here. Wait a minute here. A person who is invested in love seriously, the first thing that comes to their mind is not evil. They're the person who's trying to reason things out. This is serious. This is serious. This is serious. This is serious. Let me do this for a quick moment. Jackie Hunter, I don't know where she's from, but she sold a seed tonight into this message of $600. Whatever your need is, you're going to get it. See, because seeds changes cycles. And I'm signing your book right now in the name of Jesus. And I'm believing that yokes are going to be destroyed in your life. Whatever your request is on this seed, we release miracles for you in Jesus' name. Shannon Loving sold a seed of $60. I'm signing your book right now in the name of Jesus. Go to the phone, 855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD. Somebody said tonight, you know, $58 is not enough to even destroy a yoke that's inside my life. I know what I got to do. I got to sow an uncommon seed of 777, and they do it. I got to sow an uncommon seed of $600, and she did it. I got to sow the seed of $60, and she did it. Listen, when my mother was alive, she says, boy, when you get in trouble, get a seed. Sow a seed and place a demand on the seed and watch God perform miracles for you in your life. 855-730-WORD, 855. Say, listen, stop trying to get something for nothing. I'm not selling these books. I'm seeding, sowing these into your life. But I want you to respond because there is a breakthrough behind your obedience tonight in the name of Jesus. The scriptures teaches us the power of love out of the text. And I got to wondering to myself, what is a man looking for in a woman? What is a man looking for in a woman? Now, I just sensed in my spirit females picking up pads all across the country, and they're sitting like this saying, okay, tell me, because I want to know what they're looking for. Men are looking for a bottle of water. They're looking for a bottle of water. They're looking for four things that makes up one woman. Four things that makes up one woman. They're looking for a cap, a container, they're looking for a label and content. A cap, a container, content, and a label. That's what they're looking for. They're looking for that. And you can't go around through life uncapped, lady, spilling your resources and expect to be valued. First and foremost, the message tonight is going to cap you, is going to place that seal back on you. I don't care what has happened to you in the past. New creature anointing is about to hit you right now so that the content is sealed for the right individual. He's looking for a label. What label? What's in the label? For some, he's looking for a housewife. Others, he's looking for a mother. Another one is looking for a lover, a freak, if I might say that. Looking for someone, you might be involved with an individual whose relational situation is of such, whereas they, the person has been grown in other in another person's soil. And so you're meeting up with the guy who was planted in another garden, and now he's planted in your garden, and you notice that he's kind of tilting because he have not gone through the pruning process in times past. And since you're so used to just gathering sticks everywhere you go, you wind up having things sown in your vineyard that has no business there. I'm going to send you out tonight as a bonus for those of you who are sowing that seed. I'm going to send you my personal notes and my teachings on the relationship clinic and some secrets to the text. But I want to start off by telling you this. If you were to ask, I'm a great friend. I'm a great friend. And if you don't believe me, ask my friends. They would tell me, you're not going to get a better friend than George Bloomer. I'm a tremendous father. If you don't believe me, ask my daughters. They tell me all the time, Daddy, there's nobody like you anywhere. I just love my daddy. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm a great son. My mother used to say that. She said, you're the best son that anybody can have. You're always looking out for your mama. You're always making sure that I'm okay. If you don't believe me, ask my mama. She'll tell you, I'm a great son. They tell me that I'm an awesome pastor. Don't believe me? Ask my congregation who stood with me for 20 years through all of my ups and downs and ins and outs, through my mistakes. They were right there with me. And they keep on saying, Pastor, we love you. You're awesome. But I'm a bad husband. And if you don't believe that, ask my ex-wife. It is possible for you to be a great friend, a wonderful son, a good dad, a tremendous pastor, and a horrible husband. A horrible husband. And it doesn't mean that you're running with women all the time or drinking or not paying bills. Sometimes your greatest mistake is that you just don't know how to speak woman. You just don't know how to speak woman. Woman is a language that you have to learn. It does not just come easy. It requires an interpreter, someone to interpret the grunts, the winks, the nervous laughs, the smiles, etc. And if you don't know how to speak woman, you wind up neglecting her, thinking that she's always complaining. I know I'm going to run out of time with this. There are a few things that you must understand. 10 things you must have before you start dating and trying to be serious about dating. 5 things you must have. 5 things you must have before you start getting out there talking about you're going to be dating somebody. You must have a strong spiritual foundation. You got to be intelligent, compassion, independence. You got to have goals, man. Yeah. And you keep on picking up folks that don't care nothing about you. 5 things she must have. 5 things he must have. Ladies, stop picking up these guys that ain't got no job. They got to be able to communicate intelligently. Intelligently. Woo! They have to have a stable residence. Can't be living with their mama down in the basement. They have to have the ability to take care of himself and a strong spiritual foundation. You got to have some deal breakers inside your life, because if you do not establish deal breakers, you start picking up things from every which way. And you must understand that not all men, but most men are like cell phones. We're like cell phones with plans, and we have a plan that covers a certain area. When we go out of our coverage, we start roaming. You have to make sure that we stay within our coverage plan, because when you start roaming, it starts costing you. So you start paying for something that's already included in your plan. These yokes in your life must be broken tonight. And that's why the Lord calmed it down just a little bit so we can have a discussion with you. Preaching all across the country, best-selling author, ministering to people, living in mansions and flying private jets, and in my home, losing my wife, losing my family, because I did not understand the language of women. You got to learn how to speak woman, man, and man. You got to learn and allow yourself to speak woman. And woman, you got to speak man. It's extremely important. I want you to get this entire series because my time has ran out. There are 10 deal breakers, and there are 10 things that you must have in order to fulfill a proper relationship. 855-730-WORD. Your seed of $58 is going to help me to continue to do what I do, to minister across this nation, to keep the lights on in this place, to bless you with messages like this. Someone is about to have a spiritual breakthrough tonight. I don't want to bore you with it, but I want you to know I love you. I love you. I love you. 855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. $58. Gabby, this thing is messing with me a little bit. And the reason why it's messing with me, because I know that there's people who need to be ministered to tonight. What did you think about the word, Gabby? What did you think about the word tonight?
Bishop, is so necessary. I could name off so many people that I know who need to hear this, especially now around Valentine's Day, because people are going crazy with feeling like they need to have someone there. But instead of, you know, just trying to find someone to buy you some chocolate, it might be good to hear this first to make sure the right person is in place for this season.
You don't just want chocolates from anybody. You don't want just chocolate from anybody. You want to make sure that if you're going to give your time, mm-hmm. and you're going to give of yourself, and you're going to give of your wisdom and your nurturing and your brilliance to someone, that they at least can reciprocate. And I want to say this. A lot of young ladies are in trouble because they love with their heart. And I want to teach them how to love with their need. And when you start loving with your need, then your heart won't get broken. We'll talk about that another time. Gabby, I'm messing up the whole show. What's happening here tonight?
Whew. Well, here's another classic music moment with Tammy Hatton singing Awesome God.
He reigns.
I want you to know that they're calling in, and this is fantastic. And they're saying, Bishop, what is those 10 things, those other 10 things? Well, I'm not going to give it to you. I want you to call in and get it so that you can sit down, go over it and read it. But I'll tell you just a few of them, 10 things you must have to fulfill, for relationship fulfillment. Excuse me, I'm just speaking all over my words tonight. You must be a good communicator, must be able to protect and cover emotionally and mentally, financially. Someone who avoids problems. I don't want to give it all to you, but it's this is powerful. And if you apply these principles to your life, great things are going to happen. The phones are ringing. Jackie from Mississippi, Gail from South Carolina, Roberta from New Jersey, and Melva from Ohio. There's $58. $58. I'm going to be signing your books. 855-730-WORD. $58 is your seed challenge tonight. I need 300 of you to call and do this. It's going to be a deal breaker in your life. It'll be the most important seed that you sow. So instead of giving it to 1-800-Flowers and giving it to the chocolate people and giving it to the chocolate-covered strawberries, or telling yourself that, you know what, I'm going to send my own flowers to my own self, don't do that. Get a $58 seed and sow that seed, and let me send you some information that can bring victory to your life. 855-730-WORD. Gabby, who is our first guest for tonight?
Our first guest of the night are the leaders of Launch Ministries. Joining us all the way from Raleigh, North Carolina, welcome Pastor Al and Yolanda Morgan.
Word. I need you to stand with me tonight. I'm not leaving you alone tonight. And I know some of you at home, you're mad right now. You're mad because you found out that, you know, you just letting folk walk all over you and what have you. And he's preaching like that. My girlfriend is sitting right here. My man is across from me, and I can't even speak it out the way I want to speak it out. Well, you're going to have victory in the name of Jesus. The worst thing you can do is hear this word and continue to live the way that you're living. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. You are precious in God's sight. And the reason why he handpicked you tonight to hear this message and the rest of the message that we're going to be ministering throughout the night is because he wants you to walk in absolute victory. You know, the Bible teaches us that divorce is the same thing as death. You can experience a death in your life, that the person that you loved moves away from you and you die and never able to retrieve or to get back what you lost. I want to walk you through this season in your life. Remember, candy and jewelry is not going to do it for you this time. You need to love yourself. And I believe we have some people here that's going to help you to love yourself. 855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD. Pastor Al, Overseer Al, Pastor Yolanda, let me wave at you so I don't have to squeeze all the way over there. Good to see you here tonight in Jesus' name. Before we go into the to your discussion, your talk, let's have a little recapitulation. What did you think about tonight? Because I'm sort of like warring against some spirits right now because I want people to be free, and I can hear it in the spirit realm where they're right at the gate and all they have to do is step in.
I think that you hit the nail on the head, Bishop. I have had the privilege to sit up under your teaching. So the things that you're speaking tonight, I've applied to my life,
yes,
which have gotten me to this place. Mm-hmm. A product of divorce.
Yes.
Thought that my life was going to be over, but I found out I was that tree that you were talking about that was kind of off kilter a little bit. But through your teaching and what you're sharing with them on tonight, here I am today, standing straight up.
So this, it's possible that there is life after the death that's called divorce.
Absolutely.
What do you say to the people in the church that is just like 1,000% against it, and they think that you're going to hell and you're going to burn in the abyss because it happened to you?
Well, what I have to say to them is that, you know, people always have a word for you until that thing that they've been speaking against hits them square in the face.
Tell me about it.
See, I was one of those guys. I was Paul. You know, I was very good at persecuting Christians.
My God.
Until I went through a few things. So I grew up in a little Baptist church, and I believed that once I got married, it'd be forever. But Bishop, I found out that there's a difference in my will and God's will. And I found out what it means to have him work all things together for my good, because I made some decisions outside of God's will for me. And until I came to myself through those mistakes, then he was able to work and make those all things work together for the good.
Wow. Wow. So you married a divorced man.
A divorced woman that married a divorced man. Yes, sir.
My God. Talk to the divorced ladies then.
Well,
I didn't know we came prepared to talk about this, but Lord, have your way tonight in the name of Jesus. Because the church needs to wake up and the church needs to come alive, and we need to start having some serious, serious discussions about life.
Yes.
Bishop, I did 12 years my first marriage alone in a prison. And because the church preached that it's condemnation, that you cannot divorce. And I questioned, how do you break the unequal yoke? No one could answer me. And so I separated myself from the very people that were throwing me over the cliff and into hell. And I asked God, God, is this where I'm supposed to be? Is this the person that I'm supposed to spend the rest of my life with? And I questioned that, and I ended up in a divorce. And after the divorce, I said, God, is there anyone else for me? And I found the love of my life, or the love of my life found me. Mm-hmm. So there are many women out there that think, because they've gone through a divorce, that's it. I am here, a witness to say that you can remarry, you can be happy. You don't have to live under the condemnation of the church. Mm-hmm. You can find happiness, because it happened to us. We're walking testimonies of that.
One myth I want to dispel immediately, because there's a lot of myths and misconceptions that goes on inside the church. There's a scripture that goes like this. It says, he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth the favor of the Lord. It says, he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth the favor of the Lord. Right? He that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth the favor of the Lord. The scripture doesn't say that. The scripture says, whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth the favor of the Lord. So a doctrine got started in the church, because people tend to believe that if the man doesn't find you, then it's illegitimate. The scripture never said that. The scripture says, whoso. Whoso could be anybody.
Yes.
The emphasis is not on the who or the so. The emphasis is on the wife. Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth the favor of the Lord.
Yes.
A wife is the female partner in a marriage. So the scripture is instructing you that before you get ready to get married, go and find somebody that is already married and sit with them and gain information that will give you favor in the relationship that you're about to go into. So there are some of you young ladies who are walking by this guy dropping a handkerchief, and he too dumb to pick it up. And he ain't gonna ever find you. So you gotta help him find you, because the favor of the Lord is on you and on your life.
Absolutely.
Well, this lesson has taken us someplace. 855-730-WORD. We're talking about no suitable mate. This is a time to let things go and to embrace your new life. People are concerned a lot of times, or get concerned a lot of times when I speak. You know, you can be in a relationship and you having a wonderful relationship and the other person is having a horrible relationship.
Yes.
It's just horrible. And for you, it's just wonderful. When I said that I was a great father, a good pastor, but a terrible husband, I asked you if you wanted to know whether or not that was true by doing what? By asking my ex-wife. I may think that I'm a great husband, but according to what happened to us, apparently I wasn't as good as I thought that I was. And now that I sit back and I see that a good marriage is not just another house and red bottom shoes.
Yes.
And flying on jets and what have you. There's a whole lot. These two shall become one flesh. And the question is, which one? And so there are those tonight that are going to the altars to rededicate and recommit their lives back to God and their relationships. And I have two people who have suffered a death because you were divorced, yes, and you came together and you're living a resurrected life. And so at this point, I want you to speak to those persons who may have felt that it was over for them and they couldn't do it. And give them a thus saith the Lord tonight.
So I believe, Bishop, that there's a scripture that really covers that. And it talks about how that Paul said that when he was caught up into the heavens, that he saw things that weren't lawful to be seen, that he couldn't utter, yes, so that God gave him a thorn. So I believe that there's some people that, and your thorn might not be your issue. Mm-hmm. See, there's somebody that's watching now and you've let people make you think that your thorn is your issue. So you think your issue is that you can't find a man, that you can't find a woman, but it just might be your thorn. It just might be your cross to bear, because before you had a frame, you had a conversation with God.
Yes.
And God is taking you through this process so that he can receive the glory. I know that it doesn't seem glorious right now, Bishop, but that's what I believe we came to show people, that there's life after death.
You said that you're, before you had a frame, you had a conversation with the Lord. I believe that's Psalms 139.
Yes, sir.
He says, I knew your unformed, your unframed existence.
Yes.
So I'm getting excited now. So you're telling me that there's some conversations that me and God had before I got inside this body. And he told me what I needed to do before I got inside this body. And then I got inside this body and decided to do what I wanted to do.
Absolutely.
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 And so now I'm in the second half of my life, God correcting things, turning things around for,
yes,
me. But I stayed connected and spoken and listened to what God had told me, I may have not been in the predicament that I'm in.
Absolutely. And that's foreign to some people because we've misused our free will. Free will was given to you by God for you to worship him, not for you to decide whether you're going to serve him or not.
My God.
So most of us
say
spend
it again,
the time.
Al, say it again.
Your
it again.
Free will was given to you to freely worship God, not to freely do what you decided you wanted to do.
One more time. Because that
your
is, that is
free
the
will.
Definition of free will.
Yes. That your free will was given to you by God to freely worship him, not to freely do what you decided you want to do. So, Bishop, a lot of times what we've been doing is spending our prayer life praying for things that my free will produced.
Mm.
That's the people that are having relationship problems now. You're having problems because you chose the big hips and thighs. You chose the 6'2" frame. You chose the 6-pack, and it wasn't God's will for your life. And now you're praying
preach,
for something
preach.
That you mismanaged.
My God, my God. Praying for something that you mismanaged, and now we want God
To fix what he already gave us.
Woo!
So if I mismanaged it, it means that I already had it.
Mm.
So now, how do you ask God to give you what you had and that you laid down on the side? That's why I believe that we're here, Bishop. That's why I believe that your book is so powerful, that tonight is so powerful, because there's some people that have given up and have forgotten what God spoke to them because of their thorn. And your thorn is not your issue.
You say what to this man? You know him?
I do.
Okay.
First, I want to say thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Uh-huh, uh-huh, uh-huh.
I just want to add to that a tip that I would suggest to women is to work at your relationship.
Yes.
You're not going to have a great relationship if you don't work at it. We spend 30 years on the job. We go to work every single day. We go to work and retire from a job. But the first time your mate upset you, you walk out. You can't walk out on the thing that God blessed you with. Mm. We have to learn how to be faithful and work on the thing. Marriage is work. And that's what I learned in my second marriage, to work on making him happy.
My God.
It is my job to make him happy. And that's what I work on. And I just want to sow, Bishop. There is someone out there today that may not have the money to sow, that may not be able to sow into their happiness. And so I'm going to sow for them. I came with a love offering tonight. I'm going to give this on behalf of someone
Hallelujah.
That did not have tonight, that maybe they're calling in asking for prayer, that we we can send them a book so that they'll know how to make the right choices in the future.
855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD. We just entered into financial intercession. There are those of you who are watching right now and your relationship is perfect. You feel there's nothing going wrong with, nothing bad with it, but your daughter and your son is not doing well. Sow a seed on their behalf. Your mom and your dad is not, sow a seed. Your uncle, your cousin, your boss, your co-worker. Right now, I command you in the name of the Lord, while the anointing of the Lord is in this room, for reconciliation, for fixing things, that you get up and be a financial intercessor. Don't think about yourself, but think about someone else and sow a seed on their behalf, because a forest of blessings is about to come up in their life. This is the hour. This is the moment for sowing seed, for breakthrough. 855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. While you were talking, I could hear checks ripped, like someone was writing a you know how you ripped
yes,
it?
Yes, sir.
And I know that the Lord is speaking to several of you. I know he spoke to you to do it. He's speaking to several of you to make the difference in the life of someone else. The seed that you're going to sow is literally going to break curses in the lives of other individuals. Because for me, for the past 7 years, I have walked with a spirit of fear over my life, afraid to move into the new dimension that God has in store for me, for feeling the brokenness and the hurt and the pain of yesteryear. But about a year ago, that spirit broke off of me, and I command that spirit to break off of you in the name of Jesus. I set myself in agreement with you right now for yokes to be destroyed. Yokes are being destroyed. Yokes are being destroyed. Yokes are being destroyed. Satan, I command you in the name of the Lord to take your hands off of God's property right now in the name of Jesus. I see in the realm of the spirit a young lady who is involved with a man behind bars, and he's been locked up about 12 years. And you're locked up with him. I set you free tonight in the name of Jesus from that fake relationship. Go to the phone right now, 855-730-WORD, call and say, Bishop, Bishop, something broke off of me. Shakatanaba. Something broke off of me. I break that spirit off of you in the name of Jesus. I come against every woman who is watching right now in your relationship who have experienced a miscarriage. I sense the Holy Ghost in my spirit right now. I come against the breaking of a blood covenant. I command your womb to be strong again, to hold the deposit. Devil, take your hands off of God's property. The blood of Jesus is against you. 855-730-WORD. Call, sow the seed, destroy the yoke. Walk in victory. I command your marriage to come back together. I speak right now in the Holy Ghost, and I command all of the riffraff to get out of your life. God's gonna fix it for you. I command it in the name of Jesus, the blessings of the Lord on your life right now. Go to the phone. Go to the phone. Go to the phone. Go to the phone. Get up, 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 get up. Go to the phone. Go to the phone. Your obedience is going to destroy the yoke. Your obedience is going to destroy the yoke. Your obedience is going to destroy the yoke. You know somebody who's in trouble? Go to the phone. Intercede for them. Sow a seed right now, and I see breakthrough taking place. I'm not a prophet, but the things I see, the things I speak, comes out of the heart of God. And the Lord just told me that there are five of you watching right now, five of you watching right now, who is about to lose everything listening to people. Your seed challenge tonight is $777, 777. Go to the phone right now. Bishop Bloomer, I'm the one you're talking to. I know it. It shifted in my spirit when you spoke it. I'm gonna get up from this couch. I'm gonna walk across this floor. I'm gonna pick this phone up. I'm gonna dial that number. I'm gonna obey God, and I'm gonna walk in victory. I wanna call your name. I wanna call your name. I wanna call your name. I'm sorry, I sense the Holy Ghost in here right now. In the name of Jesus. Father, you are a yoke destroyer. You are a yoke destroyer. We send the anointing of the Holy Ghost through the airways right now and set your people free. By next week, Friday, you're gonna get a telephone call because your back child support just been released. God is doing something right now in the name of Jesus. If you got a son in prison, tonight, sow a seed. If you got a child in a messed up domestic situation, sow a seed. If your husband been putting his hands on you, sow a seed. Your seed is going to change the cycle that you're in. 855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. Oh, somebody just bless the Lord. In here, at home, get ready. The anointing of the Lord. Five of you, 777. The rest of you, 58. Five of you, 777. The rest of you, 58. Five of you, 777. Obey God. As you obey God, God is going to do mighty things. In Jesus' name, always good to have you. Always good to be with you in the name of Jesus. Gabby, where are we going from here? In Jesus' name.
Coming back to rejoice with us is Mark J. singing, I Am God.
No matter where you are in life, just remember He is God and He's always with you. Oh, yes. I see you. Why do you worry when I have a power? I heard you pray, and it's not in vain. I send my angels when you call my name, for I am God. On the throne, I sit high and I look low. I am God, I am God, yeah. The one who sits on the throne, I sit high and I look low. Yeah, I am God. Oh, yes, God is saying this. No, you're not perfect. You told some lies. That's why I sent my son to die. I'm always with you, never too far. Yeah. I am the answer, nothing's too hard. Yeah, for I am God. Yeah. One who sits on the throne, I sit high and I look. Yeah, I am God. I am God. Yeah, the one who sits on the throne, I sit high. Yeah, I am God. And He's saying this tonight, and there's no one else before me. You don't have to worry, I'll be right there. Yeah, I'll never leave, and nor will I forsake you. I'm God, I'm God. He's saying this tonight, I'll never leave, no, and nor will I forsake you. I'm God. I'm God. Come on, let's get a wave in your living room. Come on, let's go.
I will never leave.
I'll never leave you.
No one else will take you. I'm God.
heaven above with wings, yeah. Come on, somebody.
Victory is in the mouth of the believer. You shall have what you say. You shall have what you say. I sense the anointing of God very, very strongly right now for breakthrough for many people who are watching. I just came off of a Facebook Live encouraging those who are watching through streaming to stay tuned for your breakthrough. For this is the moment, this is the hour of breakthrough. It's the hour of breakthrough. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. I have some experiences in my personal life that makes me sensitive to certain spirits that are around. Suicide, I sense it very easily. Abandonment, I know that well. And I want you to understand that God's finger is up under your chin. And in this hour, chin up, because breakthrough is going to be your portion. But I have to minister to someone tonight. I got to talk to you, someone. I've asked my guests to stay for just a few seconds because I want them to minister to you. But I want to talk to you about something. There was a woman in our church, and I won't mention the name, but our pastors know about this. Before they started pastoring, you've been pastoring how many years now?
So this is our fourth year.
Four years. This is about 10 years ago. Nonetheless, she told me, she said she had a prison ministry. And her ministry was prison ministry. And I told her, no, you don't have a prison ministry. Yes, I got a prison ministry, Bishop. I said, you don't have a prison ministry. I said, you have an affection for people who are in prison, but you don't have a prison ministry. You see, because I've been to prison. I'm a product of imprisonment, of jail. And I know the manipulatorial games that prisoners can play sometimes with their jailhouse conviction. Oh, the devil is a liar. I got a prison ministry, and the devil is a liar. And so she took some of the young men and the young ladies to the prison. That was okay. But a lot of the young ladies who went, their dresses was too short, their blouses were cut too low. And she came back boasting about how that they had to move it from the chapel to the auditorium. Of course, they had young girls there. The prisoners came out to see the young ladies. She thought it was great. She hooked herself up with one of the prisoners who was behind bars and became a pen pal to him. I kept on telling her, you don't have a prison ministry. You don't have a prison ministry. Well, over a period of 3 or 4 years, he came out of prison and moved into her house. And I said, baby, you're making a great, great mistake. She says, Bishop, we don't sleep in the same room. He's just like a roommate inside the house. He has no place to go. We don't sleep in the same bed. I said, I'm not accusing y'all of sleeping in the same bed. I know you're not sleeping in the same bed. It's not the same bed that I'm worried about. Y'all sleeping in is the bed that you'll go to when you do what you do. And I don't want you to live this lifestyle. You have children in the house. Well, she left our church, went to another church where she can hide, and they received her. But it wasn't long after that, I'm preaching Bible study and she's in the back of the church. I had almost forgotten that she had gone. I'm leaving the sanctuary to go upstairs. She follows me up to my office. She breaks down when she gets to the door. She's weeping and she's crying. The man that she had brought into her house not only molested her daughter, but molested her son. Ruined their lives. I come to tell you on this Friday before Valentine's Day, that this stuff that we're dealing with is overrated. You must open up your eyes and be the protector of your household. And while the worship was going on, the Lord spoke to me and he said, tell them the story of the jailhouse conviction. Those of you who have sons and daughters in prison, sons and daughters coming out of prison, folks that you have around your children, the love of God is commanding you to wake up tonight in the name of Jesus. Pastor Al.
You know, Bishop, when you were talking and before we left out of the other segment, God gives me these crazy scriptures that most people wouldn't believe that they were relationship scriptures. And it's when Jesus makes it over to the other side. And the Bible says that there's a demoniac in the temple, in the tombs, cutting themselves. See, there's some people that's been watching that's been cutting themselves, and you're speaking against that now. And There's one thing that the demoniac did that most people don't talk about. And he says that as soon as he saw Jesus afar off, he runs and worships. I came to tell you that no matter what you've been going through, no matter what happened to you, you tuned in tonight to hear Bishop George Bloomer fall down and worship God. Nothing has happened too bad that praise can't handle, Bishop. And I believe that we're here tonight as a seed to set the captives free.
My God.
We're not good. This Valentine's Day is going to be different than the others. We don't care about no candy. We care about you getting set free. Be free now, Bishop. And the demoniac, with all the issues, it's his issue that gets him to Jesus, because that's the only reason Jesus is going to the other side.
Let's go back again. It is his issues,
yes,
that is getting him to Jesus. And the church has taught us how to hide the very thing,
yes,
that is before us that will get us to Jesus.
And that's why they placed him in the tombs, because it says that he had often been bound.
Mm.
But see, there are people, Bishop, that you just spoke against, that the little prayer partners that have been prophesying to people, but they can't bind them because they have no power.
My God.
But Jesus knew that he was coming, so he put him in the tomb so that he could find him and use his issue to set him free.
855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. Here's the problem here. The problem is when we start touching things,
yes,
that there's not enough time for us to go over the, for the whole night. And so I got to go to 855-730-WORD, because if we touch it, it's going to mess up the entire, yes, night. There is an issue, and God has concealed you in a tomb, holding you there till he gets there, because he's the only one that can set you free. Yolanda, you better take it or you ain't gonna get no chance up here.
That's good.
That's good.
That's good.
He's become a great preacher.
He has, yeah, my pastor. Yeah. I love it. I love it.
Yeah. Say thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Bishop. Thank you. I would just like to say that we're having a relationship encounter with Reverend James Smith in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina at Mount Calvary. Go to our website and get more information. But we will be there praying for people that are bound. There are widows that just think that there's no one else for them. There are people that are divorced. There are ladies that, you talked about the prison ministry, that have a prison ministry going on, dating guys that are locked up, and they're locked up in their minds because these guys are teaching and telling them, woo, all this stuff. And it's really sad, but we want to talk to you and pray for you and minister you on how to break those yokes that people placed over your lives, they spoke into your lives. We want to talk to you. Come and see us at Mount Calvary.
Listen, I want to give you an opportunity to train you how to be, how to do your own show. Give the names of those folks who sowed that seed tonight.
Yes.
Looking at Cameron, they want to hear
it. Amanda from New York, Bobby from South Carolina, Beatrice from Georgia, Sheila from all the way from New York, and we have Michelle from New York as well. Juanita from Illinois, Arnita from Michigan. We have Sonyette from New York, and Dola Jean from Maryland. We are believing God for you. And these prayer requests are going on the altar before our bishop on tonight. And this we're believing that he's going to set you free.
This is your seed. And your seed is going to change cycles. There are five of you. Your seed is 777. Listen to me. Don't let demons talk you out of your breakthrough. Don't let spirits talk you out of your breakthrough. Listen, get that seed, sow it. I'm going to call your name on the air. I'm going to sign your books. You're getting signed books from me in the name of Jesus. But it seems that we've turned the corner, because there's a few of you who've allowed cunning voices to make you crazy. Cunning voices to confuse you. Confuse you. You're confused. You're drunk. And I want to break that spirit over your life so that you walk in liberty, in breakthrough, and in freedom in the name of Jesus. 855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. Now names are dropping in my spirit. Names are dropping in my spirit. I'm talking to you, Patricia. Your family calls you Pat. In the name of Jesus, you are being set free from addictions tonight in the name of Jesus. And you're watching. Yokes are being destroyed in your life right now. Father, I set myself in agreement for victory and breakthrough. For those cunning voices that have driven many people crazy, I destroy it now in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right, go to the phone, 855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD, $58. 58 promises in the Word of God, a dollar on every promise. Watch God turn it for you. This is the year of release. Gabby, we have in church in here tonight.
Man, are we. Bishop, you are saving somebody's life tonight. I know that. It's not a belief. I know what I know what I know. And right now, I just want you all to prepare your hearts to never be the same as we share another classic music moment from the talented Shayna Wilson Williams.
Come on, prophetically say it in your own life. Today's my day. Today's my day. Today's my day. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. You changed my name. Oh, I might limp away. Thank you, Father. But I'll never be the same. Oh.
Speaking.
Today's your day. This may be the word that you've been waiting on. Today's your day. Tell somebody next to you, say, today's your day. Come on, look past their faces and say, today's your day. It's the word of the Lord for you. Today's your day. Today's your day. Today's your day. Come on, say, today.
Gene from the UK, $58. Sherry from New York, Marilyn from New Jersey, Heidi from New York, Shirley from Memphis, Jacqueline from Texas, Natalie from Florida. You're never gonna be the same after tonight. Never gonna be the same after tonight. Yokes will be destroyed in your life. 855-730-WORD. Let me get this information into your hands so you can start working a life of victory. Gabby, I'm ready for our next guest. It's been a tremendous night. Hallelujah.
Joining us now is the pastor of Better Life Assembly, all the way from across the pond in London, England. Welcome, Pastor Philip Thomas.
Word. Tonight is a phenomenal night, and the first person that sowed a seed in this segment was Gene from the UK, and so they're watching there, and I don't know what time is it in the UK, if it's like 9:30 here, 9:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30, 3:30, about 2:30 in a.m. in the morning, and victory is there for you. Man, good to see you. Now, listen. This is a friend of mine, and he's also my European tour and conference coordinator. So I'm so happy to have him here with us on tonight. It's great to be here.
Amen. Great to be here, Bishop. Yes. Great to be here.
So where are you coming from?
I'm coming all the way from London, and you called me. And you said to me that today at the Word Network, you're dealing with relationships. And I said, I have to be here. I flew all the way across from London to make sure I was here because I believe relationships are...
So you coming off of a plane, flying all the way from London into the United States of America.
Uh-huh.
Haven't been to the hotel yet.
Not yet.
Came here.
Walked straight into the studio. Yes.
My God, you dress well. Amen.
Yes, but no, I wanted to be here. Relationships are under attack all across the world. And I believe it's strategic that the discussion today is on relationship and how important relationship is and the kind of impact that can be made. I mean, some of the points have been so powerful. The 5 points that you laid out, they were very, very strategic. And I just believe it's important for good relationship as we enter into Valentine's Day, you know, for relationships to go well and it to be a blessing in people's lives. So I had to be here from London.
Yes. How long you been pastoring?
I've been pastoring now for 12 years.
12 years. And did you take over the church, or did you or did you start it?
I started the church myself.
Okay, you started the church yourself 12 years ago. Yeah. How many people did you start off with?
We started initially with four people.
Four people?
Yeah, just 12, a little group.
12 years ago. And I said that because I see that you spend a lot of time here in the States, here in the country. And so tell me a little bit about travel, or relationship, ministry. How do you pull it and hold it all together?
Yeah, that's important. I believe, Bishop, that quality time is essential. And I've made a decision this year to spend more time with fewer people.
Wow.
More time with less people.
More time with less people.
Yeah, wow. So spending quality time with key people gets the job done. Mm. And there's some people I don't need to spend a whole lot of time with if they're not constructive to me and I'm not constructive to them. And so within my relationships, in my marriage, I make sure I spend quality time with who I need to. And me and my wife, we do that. And we get the best out of our relationship.
So it's the difference between the quantity of time, because you don't have a lot of that, and quality of time. Yeah. And sometimes a lot of people spend a whole lot of time together getting nothing done, and then you can spend a little bit of time, but it's intentional.
Yes.
And so it works better. I understand that.
Exactly.
So when you're traveling, who takes care of the church?
My team does, and my wife does, and my eldership board take care of the church. They're doing a very good job, doing fantastic. A real blessing. As you know, I'm traveling extensively.
Yes.
But it's really important to have key people in your life. I recognize in this building, there are different walls, but some of the walls are what I would call cosmetic or aesthetic walls. Mm-hmm. And some of them are load-bearing walls. Mm-hmm. They all look the same, mm-hmm. but if you scratch beneath the surface, some of those walls are doing different things.
Yes.
Some of them are holding the structure up. And so the people that we have to have close in our life are people that hold us up.
My God.
People who make an impact so that we can go where we need to go and press towards our destiny. Very vital in having that.
Different types of walls, cosmetic, aesthetic, and then load-bearing walls.
They hold the structure up.
They hold the structure up. There's another wall that they have also. It's called a firewall. And the job of the firewall is to keep the fire out of the main organism, the vital part of the ministry that makes it happen. And you got some folks in church who don't know how to do nothing but start fires.
Right.
I want you to stay right there, because we're going to come back to you in a few minutes. Because we're going to go to some worship, and then we're going to come back and talk a little bit. 855-730-WORD, 855-730-WORD. Your seed of $58 is needed. I arrest you in the name of the Lord. Get up, go to the phone, and do what God is calling you to do. There are five of you. Your seed is 777. I hear you. You're there. Do it. Obey God. Gabby, tell us.
Taking us further into worship is the very anointed Amish McDonald singing Everlasting God.
Somebody just begin to open up your mouth and release worship wherever you are. And just begin to declare, Father, you are an everlasting God. Come on, wherever you are, just begin to open up your mouth and lift up worship. Love is our worship tonight. Come on, just begin to open your mouth and release worship in this room. Hallelujah. The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? I will wait for you. Somebody say, I will wait for you.
give you praise tonight. We lift worship to you tonight. Our worship is our love responding to your love tonight. And we join in all over the world. And we join in with worship. And we declare that you are an everlasting God. Come on, wherever you are, let's lift it up together. Yes, the Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? One more time. The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? And whom shall I be afraid? Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? And I will wait for you. Yeah, yeah. I will wait for you. Somebody say, I will trust in you. No matter how hard it is, Jesus, I will trust in you. Somebody say with me, I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. Whatever you're going through, I dare you to say this. I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. Now somebody lift up a worship. Yes, we lift up worship all over the world. You are an amazing God. Yes. Oh, you are the everlasting God. You are the everlasting. We set our hope on you. We set our hope on your love. We set our
and receive. I feel his anointing in this place. Ashakataraba. Rokobo shandaraba sakatababa.
I will remain. In the goodness of the Lord.
I will remain.
I will see 855-730-WORD.
855-730-WORD. I will remain confident in this and receive the goodness of the Lord. There is a word that's been spoken over your life that cannot fail. That cannot fail. Embrace that word tonight. In Jesus' name. Man of God.
Man, that was powerful. My God. Bible speaks about in Kings chapter 5, speaks about Naaman. And the Bible says that Naaman was a man. He was a good man. He was honorable. The Bible says that he was a mighty man of valor. But he had some internal issues.
My God.
He was a leper. And some of us, sometimes we may have public credibility, but internal problems. And what the good book said is that when Elijah told him to go down and dip in the river seven times, that he was walking away from his destiny because the river was dirty and it was muddy. And the Bible says that his servant stopped him and says, Naaman, have you seen what you look like? And I believe that everyone in their life needs someone who will tell them the truth, will tell them something. It may not be popular, it may be not what they want to hear, but it will be the truth. And when we find those people in our lives, we don't remove them and we don't replace them, but we keep them there because they will help us get to where we need to go.
My God.
And move us to the next level. And let me say this, that he was told to dip Naaman seven times in the River Jordan. He didn't want to do it because the river was dirty and the river was muddy. But he had to do it seven, not five, not six, not four, but seven, because there was a message that he was going to learn from going through the mess. And everyone that has faced a mess in your life, everything you've gone through, there's a message.
Woo!
There is a message that can tell you how to be a better person. We were speaking about divorce earlier. Some people's gone through relationship breakdown, but you went through that mess because God wants you to be stronger. He wants you to be better, and you're going to be pushed towards your destiny. Get ready, because goodness is coming to your house. God is turning your situation around, and great blessings are getting ready to come. You've been through a mess, but it's your time to come out looking clean, and for you to come out looking blessed, and for the favor of God on your life. You're going to look better than what you went through. You may have gone through one way, but you're coming out cleaner than when you went in, because God is in control. And there's a blessing with your name written on it. It's your season for intentional breakthrough. It's your season for divine promotion. And it's your season to be propelled to your next level of destiny, in Jesus' name.
I will remain confident in this and receive the blessings and the goodness of the Lord. Your mess has an assignment to it. There's a prophecy concerning your life and your walk. I like what you said.
Amen.
You said, Naaman, do you see yourself? You're cursing the dirty water, but you're a leopard. You're dirty, and you're cursing this dirty water. Victory is your portion tonight. 855-730-WORD. 855-730-WORD. Listen, we only got about 8 minutes to the entire show, but someone is approaching a Jordan in your life, and you need a breakthrough. Let's go there. I will remain.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Let's go there.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. We set our hope on you. We set our hope on your love. We set our hope on the one who is the everlasting God.
No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're dealing with, no matter what the attack is, I will remain confident in this, this, this. He that have begun a good work in you will perform it, complete it to the day of Jesus Christ. Your breakthrough is right now. I pray for that mother. I pray for that father. I pray for that son, that daughter, that school teacher, that nurse. I pray for you. I pray for those of you who have gone through a very, very traumatizing relationship. I want you to do one thing. Remain confident in this. Woo! For the goodness of the Lord is about to overtake you. Shakata namasakaba. Rokobo shata. 855-730-WORD. Sow that seed. Don't let a busy signal hinder you from a breakthrough. Don't let a busy signal hinder you from a breakthrough. Get that seed in. Get that seed in. This is your hour. This is your moment for a breakthrough. It's your hour, your moment for breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Monica from Indiana. Denisha from New York City. Angela from LA. They're calling in. Continue to call in. Your breakthrough. Your breakthrough is connected to your obedience. Phillips, I want you to pray for people across the pond and around the world. Go ahead.
Amen. Father, we thank you right now. We give you the praise and the glory. We thank you for the Word Network, this global mission and this global ministry touching the four corners of the world. Father, we pray for people all across the world. We pray that you will bestow a blessing on them. And those that are sowing a seed, we pray for the blessing of 100 times more to flow into their life. Lord, as they begin to sow, we pray they would step into their harvest, and we pray they would step into overflow. For we know that it is their season to be blessed. Cover every relationship, every marriage. Right now, I pray that all across the world, marriages will start coming back together, that relationships will be well. Begin to mend hearts, broken hearts. Begin to transform situations. And we give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen.
I want to get this into your hand and into your life, because I'm confident in this, that if you receive it, you shall receive the blessings and the goodness of the Lord. I sense so strongly in my spirit that tonight is a night of victory, reconciliation, and breakthrough. I just can't stop worshiping. Amish, you picked the right song tonight. You did it. That's the right song. That's the right song. If I could sing, I'd sing with you.
Confident in this, I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Woo!
I will remain, no matter what the odds are. I will remain, no matter how hard it gets. I will remain confident in this, I will see the
They're calling in from all across the country and literally around the world. 86 million homes this message beams into, and 200 nations around the world. And God thought enough of you tonight to intercept all the teaching, all the dancing, all the rejoicing, to let you know that he loves you with a supernatural love. That the love of God is more powerful than anything else. That he is here to forgive you, to mend your broken heart, to bring you back to a renewed state. This is your hour. This is your hour. Look, Naaman was a great man, captain of the guards, all of that, but he was a leper. And God had set up an appointment for him with destiny in a dirt pile. Get to the place that God has prepared your deliverance. And when you get there, Oh, I feel it. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hasha katabo sakaba. There's a war cry about to take place in the name of Jesus. And it's dropping right in your home, right where you are, in the name of Jesus. You got one more thing to do, and that's to get up from where you are and go to the phone and dial that number, 855-730-WORD, and say, tonight, I will remain confident in this to receive the goodness of the Lord. Oh, shakatabasata. Oh, shatarabasakadaba. Oh, I will remain confident.
Confident in this, I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will remain
confident in this, I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Anna from Texas, and Lottie from New York City, and Charlotte from California, and Wilma from New Jersey, and Kenny from Mississippi, and Ann from Florida, and Love from Los Angeles, and Sandra from South Carolina. I will remain confident in this and receive the goodness of the Lord.
Of the Lord. 855-730-WORD.
And even as we go off the air, I want you to remain confident in this, that the God that started will complete it in your life. Bye bye. See you next week on Rejoice.
Been a Word Network special presentation brought to you by the friends and partners of the Word Network all over the world.
To help us spread the gospel around the world, the Word Network would like to send you a powerful presentation called The Bible Experience.